I'd like to say I'm thankful to be here today, and I'd like to thank the people who have come out to support this issue. This is an issue of great concern to many. I'm a Republican. I'm standing amongst a bunch of Democrats over here. But no party is right all the time. We all make mistakes.
That's right.
And then we have an issue here that is common sense and logical, and we need to take a new look at it. I'm glad to be part of a respectful, positive petition of our elected officials to consider a new course on Medicaid expansion. We are gathering to strongly recommend that our leadership look at going a different path. The path the legislators are on right now is already causing stress on our hospitals, and especially rural hospitals. Our rural hospitals could hardly survive in the past due to the reimbursements for indigent care. Without Medicaid expansion, the reimbursements are falling, and hospitals like the one in my hometown are on the brink of possibly even closing. The closing of critical access hospitals is critical. The reason they're called critical access hospitals is because they're critical.
That's right. That's right.
If you don't have critical access hospitals, people needlessly die. That's a fact. We're talking about life or death here. People will die. This is not debatable. Nobody can come out here and debate if people are going to die or not. It is a certainty. I understand the governors and the legislators are concerned that federal funding promises may not be kept in the future. Their concerns may be very valid. All right. But the way to deal with a federal government issue is at the federal level, not here in our state. In my opinion, to save lives and health care access, the state representatives should accept Medicaid expansion and then lobby the federal government in order to mediate any concerns they have. Use all the influence and power that our state government has to try and shore up those concerns that they have.
Yes.
You can't let hospitals close and people die to prove a point.
That's right. Yeah. That's right. Woo.
We can't negotiate our concerns about future Medicare reimbursements from the federal government with closing our rural hospitals and citizens dying. I want to make it clear that I understand, appreciate, and agree with a lot of the concerns that the legislators have. But I do not in any way agree with letting reimbursements fall to our rural hospitals, critical access hospitals, resulting in hospitals closing, and in the future, hundreds of thousands of North Carolinians without emergency room services. I think this is plain and simple.
That's right. That's right.
Forget about the billions of dollars that will come to the state in form of jobs and actual money for health care. Forget about the 25,000 new jobs. This is, as Dr. Barber says, a moral issue. Now, Dr. Barber and I don't agree about everything.
That's right.
Most things.
That's right. That's right.
Most things we don't agree with. All right?
That's right.
But our governor and legislators, they're good people who disagree with us on this issue.
That's right.
I hope they reconsider and decide to focus on federal reform to mediate their concerns and don't let our rural hospitals suffer and our poor suffer. Don't let our hospitals close. Rural citizens dying shouldn't be soldiers of our legislature's defiance.
Yeah. That's right. That's right. That's right. That's right.
I've been called a little rough around the edges, and I've also been called unpolished, which I take with pride. But it's like, for example, this issue. Whenever I bring up life or death, people look at me strange. I had an attorney just Monday, when I talked about people dying at our hospital if it closes, smiled at me and said, "Well, this person you're talking about now, exactly how many preachers do you all have that have been saved by the emergency room recently?" Well, I wasn't even talking about a preacher. But the healthcare industry has a problem, and they're forgetting about life and death.
That's right.
And they need to work together with our Democratic and Republican representatives and find a solution to this problem. This problem is something that's on a plane way above politics.
That's right.
Because people are going to die. And when I say people, we need to look at that a little closer. You know, this man right here, if he were to die because he didn't have access to an emergency room, he's probably got some children.
That's right.
He's got a mama that loves him.
That's right.
He's got a wife that may love him if he's married. All right? All right? He's got a nephew that's dependent on him to help him out in college with a little extra spending money. This man goes away, there's a problem. All right? If my little 9-year-old girl dies, there's a problem.
That's right.
We got to do something, and I hope that we all work together, we all stand up for what's right, and get these legislators to turn around, accept Medicare expansion, and then deal with the other issues as they come. Don't let the poor people of North Carolina be the soldiers of the defiant.
Okay.